Well, the recent deal between Manila and Washington expanding their defense cooperation, raising eyebrows as it will include giving American troops access to 4 more bases in strategic areas around the country. One of those opposed to this move is Cagayan Governor Manuel Mamba, whose province has been mentioned as a possible host of the joint military facilities. Governor Mamba now joins us here on the program. Governor, good afternoon to you. Thank you for joining us today and welcome to the program.
Good afternoon to Carmina, and thank you for having me.
All right, we really want to get your thoughts on this. Yesterday, we talked to AFP spokesperson Colonel Medel Aguilar, and this is what he told us. He told us, to those who are opposed to this, consider the economic benefits that these additional EDCA sites will bring into your province. What is your reaction to that?
Well, I don't think that could economic benefit for our province if we are connected to China.
Right.
We are in the verge of since I was governor of the province, I said to look northward and then move northward, and on my last term to connect northward. China being one, if not the richest country in the world now. And China who created the biggest middle class in the world, and China being closest to us. Our port of Apari, which was closed 30 years ago, is a mirror port of all ports in China. And we can see a lot of hope and a lot of exchanges and international trade exchanges in due time when we are open, when we could open our port. And we feel the presence of American troops and American forces in the area is not welcome at this point in time, being a nuclear power, and we could also be subject to nuclear attack in the future. And that is why we oppose this, because we are now having some we see the interest of China also for the province to be connected to them. And as you can see, the president himself did a very bold move of visiting China and having some agreements with President Xi by signing an agreement that there will be continuous dialogue for this maritime dispute. That means we are trying to prevent war, we're trying to prevent any animosity between the two countries. And the second agreement, which was which has something to do with agriculture and fishery. We are an agricultural country, province. We are in agricultural, and we have a lot of fishery areas in the province. We have island towns and island municipalities and island barangays in the Babuyan Island, which is part of the province. And this will all be, and furthermore, we do not have an international airport here, a commercial international airport, and we are a tropical country. We could provide the best beaches also to our Chinese tourists if the time would come. And the third agreement that they had was the Maritime Silk Road. And that means building of ports and seaports and airports, especially in Northern Luzon. And when you talk of Northern Luzon, you talk of Cagayan and the whole of Northern Luzon.
Governor, clarify. Yeah, sorry to cut you there, but clarify this for us. Does this mean that your opposition to the presence of joint facilities there in your province is not so much about what it could bring, the unwelcome development that it could bring to your area, but it's more because that you see China as a more formidable partner, at least for Cagayan? Go ahead, Governor.
Yeah, that is true. That is true. As I was saying, it has created the biggest number of middle class in the world, and they need our food. China is a temperate country. They only harvest once a year. We are a tropical country. We harvest 3 times a year. That means if and when we are able to maximize our agricultural potential and our fishery potential, we could be exporters of all of this that we could not even sell right here in the country.
But when you talk to the... But Governor, when you talk to the military, they're not mentioning all of these that you just mentioned. They're mentioning joint training, exchange of technology. They're mentioning more prompt response when it comes to disasters. How will that affect the picture that you just mentioned to us? How
that
will the presence of their presence affect what you just mentioned? Go ahead, Governor.
That is not true. No. We had two super typhoons and a mega flood in the last 6 years. I never saw any American here. It was the Chinese who gave us a lot of rice and a lot of help, no? As far as the goods that were needed by our people. There were no Americans during our disasters. It's only now that they're trying to respond. No? In fact, they just gave us small boats as if we are a barangay and this is a province. No? It's so insulting. So it's not that they could be our partners, but we are more interested of our neighbors that became so rich the last 40 years.
But what about the other side? What about the other side of that hope that you're mentioning? The other side of the assistance that they've been given, that they've been giving. The other side there, of course, is their sweeping claims over the South China Sea, the West Philippine Sea. There continues a continued aggression towards our fisher folk. That's the other side of it, Governor.
Well, that is the very reason why our president has an agreement with them to talk it over. No, neighbors, no, I am at the foot of the Cordillera. I have boundary disputes with Kalinga and Apayao. We never quarreled over it. We tried to manage it. We tried to talk about it. And that is what the president wants, no, and that of President Xi Jinping, that never quarrel on this. In fact, the first time this has propped up, China said that we have bilateral talks, but we decided to go to the courts. They are not amenable to the court's decision. That is why maybe this is happening. But we could talk it over and over and over, because disputes like this, especially boundary disputes, could never be settled. They ask for more, we ask for more, and the middle ground will never happen. That is why we have to talk about it every day if there is a need for that, because this is the only way we could settle our differences with them as far as maritime dispute is concerned and boundaries are concerned. Even neighbors, we do have that, even neighbors. And in a small scale, you always quarrel with your neighbor because of this, but you could always talk it out also all throughout, and you could be there where you are. And I think this is a brilliant move of the president of having continuous dialogue regarding the maritime issues. But for the meantime, you have to coexist, you have to be there, and you have to have good relations with your neighbors.
But where is that good relations, as you said, with your neighbors, when almost as soon as the president told the public about this agreement with China, the harassment happened with our fisher folk. There's also the issue with the Philippine Navy. How can you even trust the word of China at this point? Go ahead, Governor.
Well, China never invaded us. They were never our conquerors. They came in as peaceful people. They came in as merchants. They never had their guns and they never had their cannons with them. It was the Americans who came in with their guns and their cannons. It was the Spaniards with their guns and cannons and their swords. The Japanese came here as conquerors, but not the Chinese, never. And especially for us, no? We have Chinese communities all over the province and all over Northern Luzon. And I feel that it is now time to trust them too. They have become as rich as they could in the last 40 years. This is a miracle. It was an economic miracle, no? unprecedented in this war. Shouldn't we be part of that too? Well, this is our time, especially for the province of Cagayan.
No? Let's talk about your constituents now, Governor. Talk to us about the perceived ramifications that having an EDCA site in your province would bring. Talk to us about the environmental cost, the social cost. Go ahead.
You know, America is a nuclear power country. We are not a nuclear power country. Any nuclear power force present in our province, that will our province will be a magnet of nuclear attack of any nuclear power country. If we do not have these people in our midst, nobody will attack us with their nuclear weapons.
Even if it's explicit in our constitution that no nuclear weapons our constitution explicitly states or prohibits the presence of nuclear weapons here in the country. You don't believe that that's not going to happen with the presence of these EDCA sites?
That is why I'm saying that we should never allow anyone with nuclear power, no, stay with us, or any stranger for that matter. Only Filipinos will be here to protect the interests of the Filipinos. It is now time for us to decide on that. It is now time for, and the president did a very bold move by having disagreements with the president of China. And let us give it a chance. No? Let us give it a chance, no, for them to talk it out. No? Anything, any dispute, no, that would erupt should put us on the table, not in the battlefields. And I want that to be the policy of our nation towards our neighbors.
As a final question, Governor Mamba, you know, as I was talking to Colonel Aguilar yesterday, he said that he wishes that there could be, of course, I'm paraphrasing him here, but the point that he was making is that you guys talk about the common goals, and after that, maybe you could set aside differences and work towards a common goal. Basically, that's his point. So the question now is, I guess, Governor, what would make you reconsider if indeed your province is selected as one of the four EDCA sites that they're looking at, Governor?
I don't see any good thing that comes out of it if we have a nuclear powered country whose forces are here with us. That will ignite something worse and for us. So I believe that we should do this by ourselves. Vietnam won over because they have the will to fight. They do not have the weapons, but they have the will to fight. Millions of them died, but they were the victors of a country against a superpower. Why? Because they have the will to fight. And that is what we need in our country. No? To be as free as we should be. We should never be dependent on anyone. And that should be inculcated into the minds of every Filipino and Cagayano.
And we are going to have to leave it at that. Again, Governor Manuel Mamba there joining us this soon. Really appreciate you taking our Zoom call. Take care and keep safe.